check on my dog. Hands on back. Feet on floor. Tigers, roar. Feet yellow, sir. Courtesy, sir. Thai tigers are the best. North and south. East and west. Guard stance. Back fist. Twist and punch. Turn the foot. Pizza kick. Slide up. Summit kick. Feet yellow, sir. Courtesy, sir. Alright, guys, we're working on speed this month. Alright? So, this week, we are working on the illusion of speed. Say the illusion of speed. Alright, the illusion of speed is when you look fast, but you're not actually fast. Alright? So you trick the bad guy into thinking you're fast. Doesn't that sound cool? Alright, I'm going to teach you guys how to do it. Alright? So, I need you guys to get in guard stance, belly buttons that way. Guard stance! Take this hand. Do back fist. Make sure that back fist is super high. Back fist! Alright. So, the back fist should be as high as your head. Right? Now, with this hand, we're going to do twist and punch. We're going to punch at the bad guy's chest. So, back fist to the head, and twist and punch to the chest. And feet yellow, sir. Courtesy, sir. Alright, when we back fist the head, if we hit up here, which way is the bad guy going to block? The bad guy is going to block up here, right? If we hit here, the bad guy is going to block up here. If the bad guy is blocking right here, what's open? We can hit their chest. So then we twist and punch and hit their chest. And feet yellow, sir. Courtesy, sir. Alright. I need you guys to get a pillow or a stuffed animal. Alright, parents. You're going to need a pillow or a stuffed animal. Alright? If you have two small ones, they can have one in each hand. That works even better. So, what you're going to do is you're going to take the pillow and you're going to swing at your tiger. Alright? So, if I have two small ones, I'm going to swing from up high and I'm going to swing from the side. Alright? Tigers, your job is to block all of the stuffed animals. So if they're trying to hit you up high, you block it. They try and hit you from the side, you block it. Alright? And parents, your job is to confuse them. So if they block up high, they leave their chest open, then you hit them with the other one. Alright? Cool. Alright, tigers, you just got beat up by a bunch of stuffed animals. Now, it's payback time. So I need you to get those stuffed animals, get them ready, and now, you are going to use the illusion of speed. So, parents, your job is to block whatever they hit. Tigers, you guys are going to hit high, and then you're going to use the other one and hit the chest. Make sense? All right. Parents, help them out. So, if they swing high, you block high. And then, if your chest is open, then you leave an open target, then they can hit it. Make sense? Cool. Alright, here's another trick for the illusion of speed. Alright? To look super fast, always stay moving. Alright? So, parents, what you guys are going to do is, first, you're going to put your hands right here, and tigers, you're going to block whatever they throw at you. So if parents, you block up here, or you hit up here, tigers, you're gonna do an up block. Alright, you're gonna stop their hand. Then, once they've got the hang of that, parents, you guys are gonna move your hands around. Alright? And you're gonna confuse your tiger. And then, at any random moment, you're going to tap them on the head. Alright? You're not gonna move any faster, but you're gonna look like you're moving faster. Because you're confusing them. Make sense? Cool. Alright, tigers, now it's your turn. You take your hand, and you're gonna bop your parent on the noggin. Bop. Did they block it?
Ah.
Alright, now you're gonna move your hand around. So confuse them. Confuse them. Start waving your hands around. And ready, set, bop. Did they block it? Oh, let's try again. Alright, move your hands around. Maybe start walking around them. Start to confuse them. And whenever you're ready, you're going to bop. Did you get them? Awesome. And here you go, sir. Courtesy, sir. Alright. Tigers, I need you guys to take your right knee. Wave it. Wiggle it. Alright. You're gonna put this one on the floor. Say, take a knee, sir. Alright. So you guys know the song Twinkle Twinkle Little Star? Alright. I want you guys to make a diamond. Put it in the sky. So we got diamond in the sky. Now, you're gonna put that diamond on the ground. So I turn this way. Put diamond on the ground. Now, you're gonna take this leg and you're going to side kick and bring it back and come back here. Make a diamond on the ground and side kick. And feet together, sir. Courtesy, sir. Alright, let's try this. Take this knee. Take a knee, sir. Make a diamond. On the ground. Alright, let me see this knee. Bring it all the way up. And side kick. Now bring it back. And put it down. And stand up. Alright. Parents, what's going to happen is you are going to knock your child down. Alright? So, if you have someplace soft that you can do this, that'll probably be best. Alright? You're going to knock your child down. Alright? And whoosh. Tigers, what you're going to do is you're going to fall. You're going to do take a knee. Diamond on the ground. Side kick. And then, feet together, sir. Alright, so practice that for a couple seconds, then we can move on with the video. Alright, check out my dot. Hands on back, feet on floor. Tigers roar. Feet together, sir. Courtesy, sir. Alright. Whenever a bad guy tries to hurt us, what do we say? I don't want any trouble. Guard stance. Take a knee. Alright, everyone wave this hand. It's going to be your left hand. Say, front punch. Now take this hand. Back punch. Guard stance. One step. Two step. Ah! Feet together, sir. Courtesy, sir. Alright. We're working on speed. Alright? And the most important part about speed is, or the most important use for speed is getting away from the bad guy. Say, get away from the bad guy. Alright. So, I need you guys to get your guard stance. When I say go, You're going to go in slow motion. You're going to take a knee. Twist and punch. Twist and punch. Guard stance. And then you're going to do this super fast. You do one step, two step, and then you're gonna run away. Make sense? Alright. Go!
I don't want any trouble. Guard stance. Take a knee. Front punch. Back punch. Guard stance.
And then, one step, two step, and run away. Alright, now we're going to work on getting up as fast as we can. So everyone, I don't want any trouble. Guard stance. Alright, super slow.
Take a knee. Back, or front punch. Back punch.
Now, I want you to get up as fast as you can. Alright? And guard stance! One step, two step. And run away. Alright, let's practice that one more time. I don't want any trouble.
Guard stance. Take a knee. Punch. Punch.
Guard stance. And one step, two steps. And run away. And feet down, sir. Curtsy, sir. Everyone, lock it up. All right. So this week, we're working on what the right places to use karate are and what the wrong places to use karate are. All right. So if we're at the karate school, is it okay to use karate? Say yes, sir. All right. Because, you know, we're at the karate school. We have karate teachers to help us do it safely, right? Right. Now, how about at home? Can we practice karate at home? Sometimes, right? If I practice karate in the kitchen, where there's a lot of glass, there's a lot of plates and stuff, is that very smart? Say no, sir. If I kick over a glass, what's going to happen? It's going to break. But what if I'm in my backyard? Can I practice karate in my backyard? Outside? Say yes, sir. Because there's nothing to break, right? There's nothing that I can break. There's nobody that can get hurt. Alright, let's see. What else? How about school? What if your friend tells you to show them all your cool karate moves that you've been learning? Is it okay to use karate at school? Say no, sir. Alright, so there are very special places where we can use karate. Alright, and that is at the karate school and at home, wherever our parents let us. Alright, so make sure that if you're going to practice karate, it's safe around you first. Alright, cool. Check out my dog. Hands on back. Feet on floor. Tigers roar. Feet down, sir. Courtesy, sir. Tiger form 6. Sir. Alright. So I need everyone to point your belly buttons that way. So your belly buttons are going to go to the left. Alright, back fist, twist and punch, turn the foot, pizza kick, slide up, side kick, And feet together, sir. Courtesy, sir. Alright, let's try it one more time. Our belly buttons are going to the left. Alright, so step back as far as you can. Guard stance. Back fist. Twist and punch. Turn the foot. Pizza kick. Slide up. Side kick. And feet together, sir. Curtsy, sir. Alright, I want to work on our pizza kicks. Right, so I need you guys to get a book or something. Alright, this is my imaginary pizza. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up my foot for a pizza kick. And I'm going to balance my pizza on my pizza kick. Alright? Alright, and I'm gonna hold it here. 5, 4. Oh, I'm gonna start over. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And put it down. Alright? And let's try it one more time. Pick up our foot, put our pizza on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and pizza kick. Bring it back and down. And feet together, sir. Curtsy, sir. All right, let's try that on our own. Tiger form 6. Sir. Guard stance. Back fist. Twist and punch. Turn the foot. Alright. Pick up that pizza. Pizza kick. Slide up. Side kick. And feet together, sir. Curtsy, sir. Alright guys, we're working on speed, so I want you guys to show me how fast you can do this. Alright, follow me. Tiger form 6, sir, guard stance, back fist, twist a punch, turn the foot, pizza kick, slide up. Sidekick. Feet together, sir. Courtesy, sir. Awesome job. Now I want you guys to run like a cheetah all the way around your room one time. Go. And feet together, sir. Courtesy, sir. All right, let's try it one more time. Take form 6. Sir. Guard stance. Back fist. Twist a punch. Turn the foot. Pizza kick. Slide up. Side kick. And, here you go, sir. Courtesy, sir. Awesome.